Hello, my name is Dr. Dimitrios Dovas. I'm an infertility specialist and also I'm the medical director of NewLife IVF Greece. NewLife IVF is the first IVF clinic in Greece licensed by the Greek National Authority of Human Reproduction. As you already know, many people seek fertility treatments abroad and particularly egg donation treatment. Greece is one of the most popular destinations for this type of treatments for many good reasons. The costs are very low, success rates are extremely high, and there are no waiting lists. Here at NewLife, we treat annually over 400 cases from abroad, so we have a vast experience on dealing with people who need egg donation. Today, I will talk to you about the process of recruiting egg donors, what tests we perform, and what is the legal framework in Greece governing this type of treatment. The most important factor is that egg donation, as sperm donation, are absolutely anonymous. This means that you do not get any access to details that could possibly identify the donor, like name, surname, telephone number, email address. But this does not mean that you do not have any information about the donor. So, during the process of matching, as we call it, when we recruit a donor and we want to match the donor to a specific recipient, all the rest of the donor's non-identifying information is shared with you. So you will be able to know the donor's age group. The Greek law states that all donors should be younger than 35, but in our clinic, we only recruit donors younger than 30. Her previous pregnancy performance, because many couples or individuals opt for donors with a known pregnancy history, meaning women who have been pregnant before themselves or who have donated successfully in the past. And obviously you do have information about the donor's details regarding physical characteristics like height, weight, hair color, eye color, skin texture, educational level, occupation, if she's left or right-handed, if she wears glasses or not, etc. Obviously, not every woman could become an egg donor. So apart from the requirements regarding her age group, she should be younger than 30, there are other requirements that she needs to fulfill before she's recruited as a donor. So she needs to be of very good general health without the presence of any conditions that could have some sort of inheritance, like insulin-dependent diabetes. She should have very good and functional ovaries, so absence of surgery in the past involving the ovaries or conditions that could affect the number or the quality of the eggs produced, like endometriosis. Additionally, we perform a very thorough screening regarding her family history, because obviously there shouldn't be any conditions in her family that could be inherited in other generations. For example, familial breast cancer or colorectal cancer. Finally, every donor goes through psychometric evaluation and screening in order to perform that she understands the procedure and obviously to confirm that she can cope with it. During the phase of recruitment, medical tests are essential in order to confirm that a woman is a good candidate in order to become an egg donor. So all potential egg donors are tested for infectious diseases, hepatitis B and C, HIV, sexually transmitted diseases. They have tests in order to confirm that they have normal chromosomes, so karyotype testing. And additionally, they're tested and screened for genetic diseases like cystic fibrosis, for example. Every woman who wants to become a donor has thorough investigations to confirm that she has a very favorable ovarian reserve, meaning that she will be able to produce a large number of eggs following ovarian stimulation. There are three ways that egg donation could be performed. The most popular type of treatment involves using frozen donor eggs. This means that the IVF clinic recruits and tests a variety of donors regarding physical characteristics and blood groups. And those women, once they complete their tests and they're negative, they're stimulated and the eggs obtained are kept frozen in the IVF clinic's egg bank. So based on the wishes of recipient couples, a number of eggs is thawed, they're fertilized with a partner sperm, and the embryos are created in order for the procedure to be completed. As I said, this is a very popular option, as there's no waiting list since the eggs have already been created and sitting in the freezer. And also the costs are extremely low since all costs associated with the process, donor compensation, medications and treatment could be divided since many couples could get some of the donor's produced eggs. The problem is that the freezing process slightly affects the performance of the egg. So pregnancy rates following egg donation treatment with frozen eggs tend to deliver about 10 to 15% lower success rates as compared to fresh eggs. In our clinic, we recruit dedicated donors, and those women are stimulated in order to produce eggs, which will be fertilized on the day of the egg collection with the partner's or donor sperm in order to create the embryos. I insist on highlighting the fact that we recruit dedicated donors because some clinics perform egg donation by using fresh eggs, but not from dedicated donors. Instead, they go through a process which is called egg sharing, in which case the donor is a woman who's having fertility treatment for herself and she's happy to donate the surplus eggs. In that case, the eggs are fresh, but they come from an infertile individual, so they do not have the potential of the dedicated donor's eggs. Here at NewLife, we fully understand how challenging it is to pursue fertility treatment abroad, and even more so if it involves egg donation. This is why we're happy to offer you a free online consultation to discuss your case in detail and assist you on making an informed decision.